You've made the homeless problem in your district a big part of your campaign in fighting back against homelessness. But going back to these attempts by Governor Gavin Newsom, are you comfortable with this, the way this has gone about, with the $750 million coming down, this sort of handed down from the state to sort of order this low-income housing? Are you comfortable with how all of this is going down?
Patrick, I always say Sacramento is the laboratory of the left. And I think it's important to frame the homeless problem in California. It represents 25% of the nation's homeless are here on the West Coast. 25%. It's unconscionable that we have this in America, no matter if you are on either side of the aisle. It needs to be addressed. But stopgap measures and rule by fiat, which seems to be a habit of our governor, doesn't help. We have something in San Diego, a stand down. It's a 3-day intervention for our veterans that services are provided. So these have to be integrated with any kind of housing. And to simply dump temporary housing in a public agency like the fairgrounds doesn't work. I always wonder the motivations with Governor Newsom, particularly keeping our schools closed, keeping our businesses closed. And it's particularly a hardship on those people in the hospitality, operations, and technology, transportation industries. So the motivations really, I think, are economic rather than helping the homeless in this case. Number two is we see this often with new technology, solar, for example, with people with questionable backgrounds like the Fixed Group, who has readily admitted they've had some financial issues in the past, coming in into a new market and trying to make a new proposal in an area they're not familiar with, homelessness and helping the homeless in this case.
Well, and lastly, would you trust your current Congressman Scott Peters to sort of dig in and look into this?
Well, this is one of the reasons I got involved, Patrick, with this election, is I don't feel that we have local representation that's visible, that's actually getting anything done. This is a huge issue for the county, for the city, for our nation. And I think it's a national issue as well as a local issue. With those kind of numbers, it's terrible. We spend over $300 million a year in local funds to try to help the homeless, either 10,000 or 15,000 people on the streets. That's a lot of money. Yet we are spending $500,000 for each low-income unit housing. I think the time and effort could be spent on lowering regulations, making it easier for builders to build low-income housing that would be more acceptable. We've reverted to what's called tiny homes here in San Diego. Have to be on two wheels, can be planted in front of your house, and would house somebody, it could be rented out. That's a measure that seems inadequate for communities. And I think it's better to look at regulations, look at ways to stimulate business rather than mandating it by fiat.
America woke up to the news of 32.9% slide. As far as the GDP, that's the worst in history as far as the second quarter goes. How do you attack this going forward? 20 million, according to the latest reports, 20 million Americans lost their jobs through March and April. So for the people, the single mom or the single dad in Del Mar, La Jolla, or in the 52nd district, how do you attack this? How do you help them?
Well, I'm a technology entrepreneur. I've built businesses. I've signed the front of paychecks, not just the back. I'm not a career politician like my opponent. And so I've been in the business of creating jobs my entire life. One thing we need to do and focus on, I think, is help our individuals get retrained. Education is key. If you think about those hospitality jobs and the jobs in transportation, they're not going to come back soon. We need to help these people to get into industries which are growing. Healthcare would be one of them. Technology is another. So educational and vocational training are critical. And I take it all the way back to how we open up our schools and give school choice into charter schools as well. DeBelloCongress.com is the website. You can make a donation on DeBelloCongress.com if you're so inclined. But I'll tell you, it's imperative we win back this House. As a Republican, we need to address issues like law and order. We're not defending and protecting our men and women in blue who are defending our communities. I think we need to step up and be heard and need to support them. So my campaign is about that. My campaign is about job creation, particularly post-COVID. My campaign is about international strength vis-a-vis China and Russia.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.